This is the physical examination of the external ear and the tympanic membrane. And the first thing that I'm going to do before we get started is ask her a couple of questions. Do you feel any pain or pressure?
No.
In your ears? How about any tenderness?
No.
Okay. Before we get started, you want to make sure that you wash your hands and also that your equipment is clean. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to ask her to smile for me. Go ahead and smile. Okay. What we're looking for here is any facial asymmetry. The facial nerve runs through the middle ear. So if there's facial asymmetry, that can be an indication that she has a middle ear infection, simply because that facial nerve runs through the middle ear. Okay, the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to turn my otoscope on. And you do that by pressing this little green button and twisting, just like that. And then it turns on and you can see the little light. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just shine the light on her external ear, which is called her pinna or her auricle. And what I'm doing is just looking on this, the front side, and also looking behind her ear. And I'm looking for any abnormalities in her skin color, the shape of her pinna, and also if there's any swelling or any growths or anything like that. So also, I wanted to show you different landmarks on the pinna. So right here is the helix. Right here is the antihelix. Here is the lobule. The tragus is right here. The antitragus. The concha is right here. Following the examination of the pinna, we're going to examine the external auditory canal and the tympanic membrane. Now what I'm going to do is put the speculum on the otoscope and it just twists on, just like that. Turn it on again, just like that. And what you want to do for this is, an adult, so you want to pull the pinna superiorly and posteriorly, so up and back. And in children, you would want to pull inferiorly and posteriorly, so down and back. And what that does is that just straightens the external auditory canal so you can view the tympanic membrane a little bit better. So I'm going to do that. Also, there is different sizes of speculum, and you want to choose the speculum that is the widest, but still fits in the external auditory canal comfortably for the patient. Now, tell me if you feel any discomfort, okay?
Okay.
Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to brace with my pinky, and I'm going to pull up and back and look in. And what I'm looking for is the external auditory canal. I'm looking for wax, foreign bodies, any inflammation, redness, blood, anything in there like that. And then also I'm looking at the tympanic membrane. And what I'm looking for on the tympanic membrane is several different landmarks. First, you'll see the cone of light on the tympanic membrane, and that is just basically a light reflex from the otoscope light. And on the right ear, it is about at 5 o'clock, and then the left ear, it's about at 7 o'clock. And then also, you will see at the bottom or the base of the tympanic membrane, the pars tensa. And then at the top of the tympanic membrane, you'll see the pars flaccida. Then you'll also see the shadow of the malleus and the inks. And then after you're finished examining the external auditory canal, on this side, you're going to do the exact same thing on the other side.